આગળ વધી આપની કંપનીમાં આપણે અન્ય મેનેજમેન્ટ સાથે ચર્ચા કરીએ. ટીમ લીડ સર્વિસીસ આ કંપનીના CFO રમણી દથી આપણી સાથે જોડાઈ ગયા છે. મેમ, ગુડ આફ્ટરનૂન, સ્વાગત હે. મેમ, સબસે પહેલે શરૂઆત કરના ચાહેંગે, હમને જો ઓવરઓલ ગાઈડન્સ દેખા ફ્રોમ એક્સેન્ચર, તો આઈટી સ્પેસ યહાં સે કાફી સેલિબ્રેટ કર રહા હૈ, બટ ઓવરઓલ અગર દેખને જાય તો વોટ આર ધ હાયરિંગ ટ્રેન્ડ સજેસ્ટિંગ નાઉ, ઓર આપ અભી હાયરિંગ ટ્રેન્ડ કો કે આપકો લગ રહા હૈ કે કમબેક હો રહા હૈ યા નોર્મલ હો રહા હૈ યા અભી ઇસમે ટાઈમ લગેગા હિસ્ટ્રી સે કમ્પેર કરને કે લિયે?
Almost after 5-6 quarters, we are seeing good pickup and momentum in IT hiring trends. Like compared to last year, same time, we are seeing anywhere between 8-10% recovery in the overall hiring numbers, mainly in skill sets like project management, DevOps, cybersecurity, cloud. So these are some of the skill sets where we are seeing the demand coming back on track. Whether it has been fully recovered, like how it was 2 years back, as of now, the answer is no. We may have to see a couple of more quarters to get a sense of whether the IT recovery has been fully back on track or not.
जी, और मैम जो ग्रोथ की आपने बात की फॉर मोर देन 20% फॉर FY 26, क्या रीज़न है इसके पीछे, और अभी आप देख रहे हैं इज इट हायरिंग स्प्रेडिंग जो यहाँ से इम्प्रूव्ड डिमांड देख रहे हैं, या कौन से स्पेस है, कौन सा सेगमेंट है, लाइक BFSI जो था लास्ट टाइम, ओवरऑल कैसे आप कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन भी देख रहे हैं?
No, we are seeing increase in IT spending across all segments. While BFSI is on the forefront, we are seeing across other industry there is an increased spend, especially on cybersecurity and project management, cloud. So these are some of the areas where the spending has increased, and we have started seeing green shoots in terms of IT demand in these industries. As of now, we are not seeing a very high double-digit growth for FY26. But at this stage, like 8-10% recovery year-on-year basis can give a very strong foundation to FY26 as well.
राइट, आगे हम जानना चाहेंगे क्वार्टर वन में हमने देखा इट वॉज अ हार्ड हिट फॉर एबिटा मार्जिन, सो इन क्वार्टर टू अगर बात करें तो कैन वी एक्सपेक्ट इट टू बाउंस बैक सिग्निफिकेंटली?
Definitely, there will be an EBITDA margin improvement consistently from here onwards, because all the margin impact areas like the NEEM impact as well as the seasonal impact in our EdTech business are all fully behind us. Now we are confident of maintaining a 20% sequential growth in EBITDA quarter on quarter for the next 3 quarters in this year. So definitely there will be a margin improvement as well as absolute profit improvement for the rest of the quarters this year.
जी, आगे बात करें यहाँ से जो सेक्टर्स विच आर डूइंग वेल फॉर यू, बात करें अगर लार्ज NBFCs, FMCG, क्योंकि अभी फेस्टिव सीजन आ रही है, रूरल डिमांड ग्रोथ को लेकर भी यहाँ से बात है, तो ग्रोथ रेट फॉर दिस टू सेक्टर्स आप कैसे देख रहे हैं?
So for us, typically during the festive quarter, we get the highest demand mainly from FMCG, FMCD, e-commerce and retail, and BFSI as well. So for us, even for Q3 and even for Q2, we are seeing good demand for consumer verticals as well as retail and e-commerce. BFSI is still, I would say, a little sluggish. We used to have a 20%, 20-24% year-on-year growth, especially during the festive quarters. But this time it's like about 10-12% growth in BFSI. And this is the same with large banks as well as small NBFCs. We are hoping that maybe by Q4 or the next budget, the momentum in BFSI will pick up.
जी, रमनी मैम, आगे जानना चाहेंगे जनरल स्टाफिंग सेगमेंट में एक टेलपिन था, हाउ डू यू सी दिस सेगमेंट ग्रोइंग, और बजटरी एलोकेशन कैसे है, इंटरनल इनिशिएटिव से इसके लिए क्या है?
No, general staffing, we are confident of maintaining upwards of 20% growth year on year because we are not concentrated with one or few sectors or industries. We cater to almost all industries and sectors in the country, starting from FMCG, FMCD, telecom, manufacturing, pharma, BFSI. And even if one or two sectors, even if there is a little bit of slowness, the high growth sectors like manufacturing and others are taking care of the fact that the 20% growth rate is sustained and maintained. And given the budgetary allocations, especially towards employment and first-time employment generation, we are very hopeful that this will also lead to formalization, because 90% of the outsourced employment industry in India is with informal sector. So the employees are not getting all the benefits, the social security benefits of PF and ESIC and all of those. And some of the initiatives which the government has announced in the recent budget, we believe that will drive more formalization, especially in the entry level jobs. And that will be directly beneficial to our business. But how much that actually translates into a top line growth or a margin growth for us, we need to see into the fine print once we get the actual notifications and the how the schemes will be implemented.
Right. जी मैम, आगे एडटेक बिजनेस के ऊपर मैं जानना चाहूंगी, कैसे ग्रोथ कर रहा है ये सेगमेंट और मार्जिन कंट्रीब्यूशन यहाँ से कैसा है?
Yeah, no, we are very bullish about our edtech business because that business is one of the high growth sectors for us as well as high margin contributors for overall TeamLease group. Last year we did close to about 100 crore in revenue, and we are expecting upwards of 25% growth in that business vertical, maintaining an EBITDA margin upwards of 8% for this year as well. We have been consistently signing up more and more universities and more students under our EdTech business. And that business will also over time will become a feeder to our staffing business for our employment cluster as well, bringing in a higher quality of candidate pool accessible to our clients in our staffing business.
Jay. And ma'am, lastly, जानना चाहेंगे inorganic expansion and possible acquisition size क्या रहेगा इसके लिए और how will you fund it?
No, TeamLease is an organic growth focused company. Even if we have to do a few M&As, that would be largely to give us some entry or give us some capabilities into specific areas. Our M&As won't be any large size deals. Typically, the ticket size would be under 100 crore. Right now, we are having active M&A discussions in HR tech space because that's one area we believe will bring in a lot of tech leverage to our staffing business and other employability cluster businesses as well. So M&As would typically be under 100 crore in size, largely in the HR tech space. And nothing concrete as of now, but yes, advanced stage discussions are in the pipeline.
Right. Ramani ma'am, thank you so much for connecting and best wishes for coming quarters. Thank you. TeamLease's management